In this video, we will explain how to determine when the Read Ignoring ECC command should be used. This command is meant to ignore the drive's error correction procedure and retrieve whatever the drive could read from the user data part of the sector on the first attempt. Judging by the definition, this appears to be an extremely useful data recovery operation. However, it has several serious limitations that must be taken into account. The key thing to understand is that hard drive manufacturers do not necessarily have to support read-ignoring ECC with their drives, because it is a part of the optional ATA command set. This means that we could receive vastly different responses to our read-ignoring ECC commands depending on the design of the hard drive being accessed. Modern hard drives could respond to this command in 5 different ways, and only one of those responses is helpful for our recovery efforts. Now we will go through the possibilities and explain how to identify them. The first possible response to read-ignoring ECC is the intended operation of the command, meaning we actually retrieve some valid user data, bypassing the need for error correction. In this case, multiple read-ignoring ECC attempts on the same sector should show similar hex results with only minor variations from one result to the next. For example, on this drive, we can see that most of the hex values are stable from one read to the next, which is a good sign. Because we are bypassing the error correction code, this data is partially corrupted, but it's still preferable to nothing in most cases. The level of corruption in the result will be affected by the number of read-ignoring ECC retries we make on each sector due to the statistical analysis feature of the DeepSpar Disk Imager, or DDI. DDI makes an educated guess on the most profitable sector content by taking the most common values for each bit out of every available result. As such, the more read-ignoring ECC retries we make, the more accurate the result should be. In some cases, it's even possible to obtain fully integral reads on bad sectors in this manner. Another thing we have to keep in mind is that these results should look like real data in hex. What real data looks like will of course vary, but the general idea is that it should have some similarities with surrounding sectors that were read using standard read commands. In this case, we can see that the sectors which we read using commands that ignore ECC are filled with AA hex values, just like all the surrounding sectors which were read using standard read commands, so this is highly likely to be valid data. Real data also sometimes has English words visible within hex results, which is a giveaway that the read-ignoring ECC command is being executed correctly, as we can see on this drive. The second potential response to read-ignoring ECC is random data that has little to do with valid user data. In other words, the drive passes on a very high percentage of meaningless read-write channel noise through the bus as a response to our command. This is easy to identify because the drive will give very different hex results for every read-ignoring ECC attempt on the same sector. The third possible response to read-ignoring ECC is the drive giving an abort error and completely refusing to process the command. This is easy to identify, since in this case red A's will appear in the sector map for every sector we try to read-ignoring ECC. The fourth possibility is a relatively new occurrence that started to show in drives that were manufactured over the last few years. Many modern drives automatically use the error correction codes within every sector for encrypting and decrypting the user data as a part of normal operation. In this case, using commands that read-ignoring ECC will bypass the decryption process and the drive will return useless encrypted data as a response. The result will not change much from one read to the next. However, the hex values will look like encrypted data rather than valid user data. Encrypted data should not have any particular patterns or full words visible in hex. The encryption algorithm is usually consistent across the whole drive, so two sectors with identical contents should produce two identical encrypted results. For example, on this drive, we can see that all of the surrounding sectors are filled with zeros, and using read-ignoring ECC produces a consistent identical result, which means that this result is the encrypted version of a zero-filled sector. There is no practical way to decrypt this data, so it's not worth using read-ignoring ECC on such drives. The last possibility is the rarest one, and it can be difficult to identify. It involves the drive returning an unrelated section of its internal buffer as a response to read-ignoring ECC. This can look very different from one drive to another. It's difficult to spot at times, because the read result might appear to have some clearly defined patterns within it that closely resemble real data. For example, on this drive, we can see one of the hex values steadily counting up with every consecutive sector. Normally, something like this would look like valid data, but in this case, because the surrounding sectors are all filled with zeros, this is actually meaningless data from the drive's buffer. Read ignoring ECC should only be used in the first scenario, when the drive returns valid user data as a response. It does not make sense to use it in the other four cases, since all it would do is waste time and potentially reduce the quality of the resulting image by adding invalid data to it. As of 2015, most modern drives do not process read-ignoring ECC correctly, but it can still be useful in some cases, especially when working on older drives. Thanks for watching.